Another question we had about relational databases were about joins, and specifically how you do a lot of more complicated queries without joins, because that seems pretty fundamental to a lot of database administrators.
Yes. joins are fundamental to databases, in particular SQL databases, and I said don't use joins. Now, a lot of this is opinion, but it's based on experience. So the reason I say don't use joins is because joins don't scale very well. So if you're writing kind of a typical web problem where you think you're going to have lots of data and that data is going to eventually need to be spread across multiple machines, running queries that involve multiple tables joining these two large pieces of data together, or potentially more than two, across multiple machines is very, very difficult. There's a lot of research going on to make that possible, but with the consumer tools, it's not going to work very well for you. You're going to have to figure out something on your own. Now, if you structure your data in such a way that everything is independent, you don't have to worry about that. Things scale a lot nicer. You have to take this into account when you start, though. You know, you need to think of your databases as basically these large key value stores, and you're not going to be able to do complex queries. You know, you're going to look up things by ID, or maybe look up things by single columns, but you're not going to be joining things together. Now, one of the things you have to do there, then, is store some redundant data. You know, if you have your data nice and normalized, that is, all of the data for a particular type is in a table for that type, and you join everything together at query time, that's a nice looking database. But as soon as you break things apart, you know, you might need to store, you know, effectively kind of cache other pieces of data in other tables. You know, on Reddit, we store, you know, a user's karma, I think, on a link they submitted. So we have that piece of data handy, so we don't have to fetch the user and the link and all that sort of stuff. So it means there's some more maintenance overhead when you do an insert. You know, when you update a particular field, you may have to update it in a couple places. But that, to me, is easier, a little bit more easier to manage than trying to figure out how do you run joins across large data sets across multiple machines. Now, if you have a small data set and it fits on one machine, great, use joins. You know, do what works for you. You know, on Hipmunk, for example, we have a database of hotels. It's 300,000 entries long. It's not getting any bigger because that's about how many hotels there are in the world. Yeah, and we use joins in that database, so it makes the problem easier. But on Reddit, you know, we have databases of links and comments and votes. Those tables can have more than a billion rows. We're not doing joins on those tables. Like, those are spread across many machines, you know, just to make the queries work. So, again, you know, use what makes sense. If you're going to be storing lots of data, try to think about how you would store data in individual tables.
Okay.